Merry Christmas!
Bit cold tonight, as you might have guessed, with the attire. What a lovely neighbour I've got, Gail. She just texted me and's gone, "You alright, Shay? Just heard you go down the stairs. You've been a bit quiet lately." I just texted her back, "Everything's good. Happy Christmas and all that." Yeah, what a lovely neighbour. Well, it's half time between Morocco and France. So, in France, they haven't even played well yet. They're going to get to the finals, and unless Morocco can do one. Now I'm rambling. Yeah, it's cold enough. But it ain't that cold. If you wrap up warm enough, it's all right. Let's get Siberian hat like this. It's that time. Not that time. Well, that's it then. France, Argentina. Come on in, Argentina. Personally, I thought I was pretty good at wrapping up presents. But they kind of stressed me out, to be honest. Right, I can only go that far, but just to the right there, to the corner of your picture, little brown envelope. Let's have a look. Normally, my spidey senses, they tell me who it is, but I ain't getting no premonition or nothing. By the way, I don't really get stressed. That's just crap paper I had lying about. But yeah, my spidey senses tell me now. That's from my Auntie Carol, because the way my name's writ, I don't know who this one's from. Chill out, nephew. Get up there, my Auntie Carol and Victor. Look at this. It's Christmas, and you know, like to find money in your guard. Very fucking funny. How about that, boys? Look, I'll delete the F in that, but fucking hell, what the f? Yeah, why no? Time to go out. It's Sunday now. I've really got to go and do this sleeping battery, because if I leave it any longer, it's going to be 60, 70 quid for a new diesel battery. Can you hear that? It's come out now. Turn things on. Put the diesel heater on. Only team in the world, boys. I'm going to take this off now. But I don't know if you can hear that diesel heater. Probably just hear it in the background. It's rapid. If anyone knows about diesel heaters, let me know. It's like it's going to take off or something. It's going that fast, but it does bloody stink of diesel in there, and also I know something's wrong. You don't want to intoxicate yourself with diesel. Them boys, they're cold. See that black there? That's not oil. And that's frostbite. Yeah, it's a bit cold. Bloody nor is it cold. It's that time of year, boys. Pull out the old 4x4s. Get a bit of proper traction on the road. I've just realised as well, I've left the diesel heater on in the van. Well, that's the World Cup final. What do I reckon? Well, it'd be nice to see Messi lift it. I'm going to go 2-1 Argentina. Right, back to dinner. There you are. There we go. Say nothing. Real socks then, boys. Look at that. It's that kind of weather.
But some of the greats.
This vanilla by Shake and Ada. Ecstasy. That's all I'm saying. Lovely. Now there's something I've learned. Wensleydale, try that again. Wensleydale cheese. It's 1,000 years old.
And nowadays, that's the Wensleydale that people would probably assume long-lasting and very economic to make. So they restricted the way Wensleydale could be made.
And so over 900 years, there was a cheese ration until 1957. Boys, as God is my witness, it should be illegal to give matchmakers away for a Christmas present. Oh, look. That's so tempting not to rap. That's all good, leave you lose battery on charge. I'll tell you what, when I talk to Ray, it's like, you talk for a minute, but you look at the clock and it's like 20, 30 minutes later. Yeah, just got off the phone with him, man. Fucking poor Savage, he's got the COVID, poor lad, so. And his missus, get well soon, Laura Gelt. Are you all set for Christmas? Hopefully you are. And happy Christmas, everyone. Yeah. I hope you're spending it with people you love and you're safe, warm, and all that good stuff. Happy Christmas. There we are, boys. Happy Christmas. Collars up, you know the rules. You ain't gonna believe this. What is my mother like? Look. Ain't saying nothing, yeah? Just ain't saying nothing. She's a character, that one. But yeah, all presented out. She's going from mad posh dinner, man, in a pub. Little gastropub. Four prawns, two of each of different types. They were coated in some of the first that were illegal. But yeah, what a great day. Time now, 5:25. And time to get back to Northampton soon. Yeah, I hope you're all well out there. Look at these cunts down here, look. God forgive me, my French. Look, it's coming up 2023. I thought you riffraff, the police would have cleared you up off the street.
Yeah, we're not allowed to do it anymore.
You're one day off.
Richie says get the camera on. That's Dips, the owner.
You're one day off.
Dips. How'd you get on Crime Watch?
He spent 12 grand modifying his latest car.
Having a nice car is a little bit about posing, and I like to sort of just not whiz around, I like to sort of pose around a little bit so that people can see your car and take it in a little bit.
The wheels, they are about £500 each. Unbelievable amount to spend on wheels and tyres, I think.
Wheels make a car, really do. Different wheels make or break a car.
When I look at those wheels, I think table, chairs. I think of that as £2,000, not four wheels and tyres.
Clive is going to pose with his new wheels at tonight's cruise in Northampton.
Before I met him, I didn't know what a car cruise was. So I suppose you could have classed me as a cruising virgin. If you don't know what goes on at these things, it's amazing. Women get their boobs out, which the men love. Men get their bums out, which the women love.
The girls go to the shows, there's guys there. Guys go to it because there's girls there. So, bit of a bonus, girls and cars. It's like going to heaven, isn't it?
Max Power pull the punters, When they show, so do more cruisers, desperate to get themselves into their favourite magazine. There's a Max Power League table for car cruisers with a bizarre scoring system.
We've got to go and find some girls. Where are the best girls? What's your name?
Georgina.
That's it. All right, hold it there.
The score chart refers to the birds, the burnouts, the arses, the police. Basically, if it's been a good cruise, they'll get a good score.
Good. Well, I'm made it. Cool. I think they're just burning them out. Just sort of spinning them until they go pop.
Creates huge amounts of smoke, which everybody loves. It makes you sick and it makes you feel really horrible, but people love it.
You remember your first time, Bucko?
No. No, it never happened.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
You've never masturbated?
No.
Oh my gosh, brother.
Mm-hmm.
Wow, man. What is that called? Is that... What do you guys call that?
Nothing, really.
There's got to be a special nickname. I think in gay culture, if it's a man in gay culture, a guy that's never kissed a woman is called a golden Oreo. Mm. So I wonder what that is. My God, brother. Damn. You must have just baby's breath inside of your nuts right now. That is damn beautiful, brother. Congratulations, man.
Thank you.
You think you'd be able to hold the line? Are you trying to hold the line until marriage, you think, or just until a relationship?
Yeah, till marriage.
Wow. Good for you, brother. And do you feel like you have more of an inner strength going on?
I do.
Yeah. You know, I had breakfast with a guy a couple weeks ago, and he'd never masturbated, and I was just so jealous. Because I masturbated, honestly, less than... probably 11 hours ago or 12 hours ago. I couldn't get to sleep and I just felt the devil just climbing up and down my penis and I just had to do something. When you get that feeling, what do? Just chill out, put your hands on ice or what?
I don't really get the feeling.
Damn! Now, what if you get erection in your body? What do?
Can't say I get that either.
What? Really?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, my God. Huh. And do you think you might have an iron deficiency or something? Or do you think it's just...
No, I think I just contain it.
Damn. You're like damn Chun-Li, bro.
Mm-hmm.
God. Dude, how far could you jump? I bet you could jump damn 11 feet, huh?
I wish.
Dang, so do you ever think about the long road you have to hoe before you're going to get to some skeet, that's what they call it in the urban community?
Yeah, it comes across my mind a few times.
Damn. I almost want to be there when it happens, brother Nahomo, you know?
I'll invite you.
Well, come on now. That might be a bit, you know, but maybe I'll be outside. If there's a window or something, I don't want to be right up front.
I'd been making dance music. I met Rollo. We met each other in the record shop Pure Groove in Archway, which was the epicenter of all things fabulous and dancey at the time. Anyway, we went to his place, watched Blade Runner, smoked a bit, went back to my mum's and made a tune. He said, my friend's a producer, his friend Ben. Rollo and Ben and I worked together a bit and Ben went off to do various things. He actually then formed various bands, one of being LaRue. So he carried on moving and shaking. It was actually through Ben that we met Maxi. Ben announced he'd met a Buddhist rapper in Brixton through his girlfriend, a South London lass. And we said, oh, that sounds interesting. And we just discovered a button on the Atari that made the tempo slow down. That was quite exciting. Obviously, French Kiss, little Louis, did it years before, but we were slightly technically chaotic and only just found that button by accident. Anyway, we slowed down, we had this house track and slowed down to a hip-hop groove in the middle. We thought, wouldn't it be interesting to meet Ben's friend, Maxi, and see what he can do with it? And we thought we'd never met a Buddhist rapper before. So we invited Maxi to the studio and we just talked long into the night about his Buddhist faith, what that meant to him, what it meant in the context of modern life, because he's not an athlete in that he doesn't lock himself away like a kind of Zen Buddhist or monk. He's really about living life to the full. From that conversation came the very first Faithless record, which was Salve Maya. And Rollo asked Maxie, like, what would you do if you were so uncomfortable you could barely live in your own skin? And Maxie proceeded to tell us about his journey to Buddhism, which is when he had no faith in himself and he was essentially faithless, that life was frustrating and difficult and, you know, led him to very dark places, and Buddhism was a bit of a salvation from that, just changing his thinking and his perspective on the world. Changed his life quite radically. After we made that record, Rollo named the project Faithless because he understood that that was what Maxie was talking about, really. So that was the beginning of Faithless, and we were actually signed by Island Records for that record, and it just sat on the shelf for months. They just didn't know what to do with it. Was it house? Was it hip-hop? It was a bit dark. It wasn't kind of hands in the air, happy house. So they weren't really sure where to put it. So, you know, we thought we don't really make music so it can just sit on a shelf. And we had a clause in our contract that said we could get the record back if it wasn't released. So we got it back and decided, we enjoyed working together so much, should we make an album? Let's put some other music around this. And yeah, so that was the beginning of Faithless, making our first ever album. It's quite hard to remember the process. It was in the garden shed in Islington, that's where Rollo's studio was, and then we mixed it in a nicer studio around the corner. It was called Swan Yard. It was quite a legendary place, and we used to get the downtime when the kind of big artists had finished in the day and we could book it a bit cheaper at night. But I think we did a lot of the demos in the garden shed. I certainly remember that we did Insomnia there. Like albums back in the day were on vinyl, they had an A side and a B side, and we needed a track to balance Salve Maya on the B side. And I can't remember if the groove came first. Often with me, it's a bass line. And I remember we wanted to go shopping because in Islington they had a record and tape exchange, and we always liked to, you know, rifle through the secondhand tunes and see if there's any like rare bits we could pick up. And I think we had a groove going. Maybe the bass line came first. And then Rollo said, oh, just do a riff. I don't even really remember what instrument I played it on, but Rollo was the one that found a sound on a Roland keyboard called a JD-800, which is a really great bit of kit. In fact, we used to get quite a lot of sounds out of there before we moved into rack mount keyboards. And I just literally sort of sat there and jammed, as I always do, and that's the riff that came out. We asked Maxie to write lyrics about getting no sleep, because at that point I was DJing loads and my sleep pattern, as most DJs, was just completely upside down, and I really couldn't get to sleep. So I literally marched into the studio and said, right, we're doing a tune and we're going to call it Insomnia because I can't get no sleep. And Maxie kind of went away and scratched his head and had a think about it. Yeah, ironically, he can sleep at the drop of a hat really, really well. Literally could sleep sitting up in that chair. But he did have an abscess on his tooth at one point, and he referred back to the agony of that and if you like, took himself back into that space, and that's where he wrote the lyrics. The first mix was a bit of a homage to Detroit. People don't really realise that. The Moody mix was the first mix before the Monster mix, which I think was the mix that took it to a place of sort of grandeur and widescreen, you know, epic vibes. But it was never meant to be a big sort of commercial hit. I mean, we were told initially that it certainly wasn't. When we took it to Radio One, we had radio pluggers, and they just said, it's got no hook, it's got no chorus, go away. And we re-released it over a year later, partly because Pete Tong campaigned for it, and partly because it was just growing in people's record bags. It was being requested, people started to recognise it, it started to connect. But like everything with Faithless, it certainly wasn't. You know, it didn't land in our laps. It took a long time. So we started playing live because we couldn't really get arrested. We got our first album out, Reverence, and nobody knew about it. Insomnia was still growing in the dance community. Like, DJs knew about it, but it hadn't hit critical mass. It wasn't on the radio. It was starting to grow as a record in Europe. So really, we put a band together to showcase the album. And we learnt very early on, because the album was so eclectic, if we didn't put Insomnia early in the set, people would think that they'd come to see the wrong band. So yeah, we used to play Insomnia twice. So people knew they'd come to see the right band, then they could relax and we could carry on playing music that was maybe a bit more uncompromising to your average dance fan. And then we'd always play Insomnia again at the end. The rose reminds me of dust storms. Where you walking, you can feel the past. And there's no one to hold on to, and there's no one to pull you out. You keep on calling, the power always stalling. So you end up self-destructing. Young mama on the rise with her sun blind. Dirty water in the veins of a bloodline. Simulated by a book to be one tribe. Dark history, I wonder was no sunshine.
I never ran from anything because I never had nobody to go to. I've always had that where I'm going. Home to get me. Ain't nobody there.
Right, right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, so it's, I've always been in a situation where I'm forced to deal with it myself, so.
Terrified for his life. This man, Irish also known as Shadow, will haunt your dreams. Listen to this.
So the Shadow is following me and I need to get to a safe house. He knows everything and is crushing our databases down like wildfire. We need biorobotics to go in there. He has all of our info and the flight plans for the next month. This is a call to Elon. Please tell Shadow to stand down. We will fix everything.
That's crazy, man. That's the leader of Facebook telling you Shadow is coming and he needs a safe house. This guy's like John Wick. I think he goes by the name. I don't know. If I can say it. Can I say it, Jamie? The Irish Shadow. There you go. Irish Shadow has a special message for you. It's like opening a present on Christmas morning. The anticipation and excitement is palpable. We can't wait to see what's in store for us as we tune into the Irish Shadow's message. The Irish Shadow is a shadowy figure, rarely seen by anyone. Some say that he is a ghost, others that he is an otherworldly being. But whatever he is obsessed with the Temple of Felix. He is also determined, and he will not be deterred. He knows that the key to fast travel between universes and dimensions is within his grasp, and he will stop at nothing to unlock it. According to a scientist at Harvard, there are exciting developments in the works. We can't wait to see what Irish has in store for us and to learn more about the world of energy. I was just scrolling through my messages today when I received a message from the Irish Shadow. It was a simple message, but it sent shivers down my spine. Let me read it out. The Earth contains a vast amount of energy in various forms, including kinetic energy, the energy of motion, the stored energy of an object due to its position or configuration. Some examples of energy sources on Earth include fossil fuels such as coal, oil, and natural gas, nuclear energy, solar energy, wind energy, hydroelectric energy generated by water, and geothermal energy generated by heat from the Earth's core. The total amount of energy available on Earth is not fixed and can vary over time due to processes such as the formation of fossil fuels. With his power and his skill, he will not be denied. He will use energy to accomplish great things and to defy the limits of what is thought possible, to break free from the chains and bring about a brighter future. For all who are Shadow is a man like no other, he has a power, a gift, that he discovered the ability to manipulate energy, to bend it to his will, a power that he wields with great skill.